Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about CBSE class 9 chapter 2. Chapter name is polynomials. Okay, so first we know that what is the definition of polynomials. See the definition. If in an algebraic expression the power of each variable are only whole numbers, then that algebraic expression is called polynomial. So If the power of each variable are only whole numbers, these two words you have to remind, that the power is only whole numbers. Okay, and algebraic, we know what is algebraic expression. Algebraic expression are some mathematical phrase which containing constant, variable and operator, that is algebraic expression. Now an algebraic expression is called polynomial if the power is only whole numbers. Okay, if the power is only whole numbers, so power cannot be negative or fraction. Okay, then that algebraic expression is called polynomial. Only power is whole number, these two words is most important for polynomial. So power cannot be integer, cannot be fraction, cannot be any other number, only the power must have to be whole numbers. These two words you must have to remind. Okay, so this is the definition of polynomial. Now take some example of polynomial, that is x² + 5x, 9y, 7. 7 is also polynomial because 7 can be written as 7 × 10⁻¹. So 7 is also polynomial. This polynomial is called constant polynomial that I discussed. So here 7 can be written as 7 × 10⁻¹, that's why 7 is also a polynomial, and this polynomial is called constant polynomial that I discussed in the next. And example number 4, x³ + 5x² + 6x, this is also a polynomial. Now see, in this 4 example of polynomial, all the powers of the variable are whole numbers. So it's this power are 0 1 2 3 4. Okay, so these are the example of polynomial. Now one question is there, is 7 root x is polynomial? No, because 7x root x means 7 × 10⁻¹, but 1 by 2 is not whole numbers. So 7 root x is not polynomial. It is not polynomial because the power is fraction, not whole number. So this you must have to remind. Okay, power must have to be whole numbers, otherwise not a polynomial. Next, I discussed about types of polynomial. There are only main three types are there, that is, one is monomials, binomial, trinomial, that we already discussed in the class 8 in the chapter of algebraic expression. Okay, and I also add two new type. So first type is monomials. If a polynomial contain only one term, for example 5x, 3y, binomials. If a polynomial contain two terms, then that is called binomials. If a polynomial contain three terms, that is called trinomials. Okay, and there is another two types, that are constant polynomial and the number 0 is called zero polynomial. Constant polynomial, the constant number 5, 6, 7, 8, this polynomial are called constant polynomial because 5 can be written as 5 × 10⁻¹. So this is a polynomial because this power is 0, 0 is a whole number. So 5 is a polynomial. Again 6 can be written as 6 × 10⁻¹. So every constant can be written as that constant into x to the power 0 in this form. So every constant is a polynomial, and this polynomial is called constant polynomial, and 0 is called zero polynomial. And there is another three types, that is linear. One is linear, 2 is quadratic, and 3 is cubic. And these types is depends on the degree of the polynomial, and degree of the polynomial I discussed after this. Now, if the degree is 1, then that polynomial is called linear. If the degree is 2, then that polynomial is called quadratic polynomial. If degree is 3, then that polynomial is called cubic. Degree 1, then linear. Degree 2, then quadratic. If degree is 3, then that polynomial is called cubic polynomial. And next, I discuss about degree of a polynomial. Okay, degree of a polynomial. So, what is degree of a polynomial? The highest power of the variable in a polynomial is called degree of a polynomial. So first, an algebraic expression has to be polynomial, then the highest power of that polynomial is called degree of the polynomial. Okay, so degree of a polynomial. For example, degree of 5x cube plus 6x square plus 7x, in this polynomial which is the highest power is 3. Okay, so that's why the degree of this polynomial is 3. And in the polynomial 3y plus 7 highest power, there is no power is mentioned, so there is 1. So the power is degree of the polynomial is 1. Here power is 1, so the degree of the polynomial is 1. Now one note is here, degree of a constant polynomial is 0. Okay, degree of a constant polynomial is 0 because 5 is a constant polynomial. Now 5 can be written as 5 into x to the power 0, so which is the power 0. Okay, so power is 0. So the degree of a constant polynomial is, degree of a constant polynomial is 0 because any constant can be written as in this form, that constant into x to the power 0, so which is the power 0. And this power is called highest power. Here highest power is 0, so the this is the degree. So degree of a constant polynomial is 0. And next thing is zeros of a polynomial. Zeros of a polynomial, this zeros of a polynomial is like the solution of an equation, is just like solution of an equation. But here we discuss about polynomial, so the concept are same. The solution of a equation and zeros of a polynomial are conceptually they are same. Let's see what is zeros of a polynomial. Let px be a polynomial and x equal to a is a value of x, is maybe any number. Okay, it's maybe any number, any real number suppose. Then p a equal to 0, then x equal to a is called 0. So for which value of x px equal to 0, for which value of x px equal to 0, that value is called zeros of a polynomial. Here for x equal to a, px equal to 0 or pa equal to 0. Okay, here x equal to a, px equal to 0 or pa equal to 0. That means for x equal to a, px equal to 0. So for which value the polynomial is equal to 0, then that value is called zeros of a polynomial. For example, suppose here I take an example of polynomial px equal to x square minus 1 and take one value x equal to 1, then p1 equal to 1 square minus 1. I put in place of x 1 in place of x, so 1 square minus 1, 1 square minus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore for x equal to 1, px equal to 0. For x equal to, for x equal to 1, px equal to 0, px equal to 0. So x equal to 1 is the 0 of the polynomial px. Okay, so this is the zeros of a polynomial. Next, I discuss about two theorem. First one is remainder theorem, second one is factor theorem. Okay, so first is remainder theorem. Without division we can find the remainder. That's very interesting. So see the statement of this theorem. If a polynomial px is divided by x minus a, then remainder equal to p a. That means the value of the polynomial at the point x equal to a, that is the remainder. Okay, when see, if a polynomial px is divided by x minus a, x minus a, then remainder is p of a. Okay, if px is divided by x plus a, then remainder is p of minus a, because x plus a can be written as x minus minus a, minus minus, minus into minus plus, x minus minus a. That's why remainder is p of minus a. So without division, we can find the remainder. This very interesting theorem, remainder theorem. So this is the statement. For example, by taking an example, we try to understand this remainder theorem. Let's see, px equal to suppose x square plus 5x. Now if it divided by x minus 1, then what is the remainder? So I have to divide this, but using this remainder theorem, without dividing, we can say that what is the remainder. The remainder equal to, according to this theorem, p 1, because x minus 1, here in place of a there is a equal to, here a equal to 1. So the remainder is pa. So here remainder is p 1 because a equal to 1. So remainder is p 1. Now put x equal to 1 in px. So 1 square plus 5 into 1, 1 square means 1, 5 into 1, 5, 5 plus 1 is 6. So remainder is 6. So if we divide x square plus 5x by x minus 1, then the remainder is 6. So we get this remainder without any division. Is very interesting, right? Next theorem is factor theorem. Okay, again, without any division, we can find a one factor of a polynomial. Let's see what is the statement of the factor theorem. If px is a polynomial of degree greater equal to 1 and a be a real number, a be any number or real number. Now x minus a is a factor of px if p a equal to 0. Okay, p a equal to 0. What was the p a? P a is the remainder that I already discussed in remainder theorem. P a equal to what is the name of this p a? P a is the remainder. Now if p a equal to 0, then that completely divisible by x minus a. P x is completely divisible by x minus a. So x minus a is a factor. Okay, so this is one corollary of remainder theorem. Okay, so x minus a is a factor of px if p a equal to 0. Again, conversely, if p a equal to 0, then x minus a is a factor of px. So remainder equal to 0, then x minus a is factor. Again, x minus a is a factor, then p a equal to 0. So this theorem is both side true. If and only if condition, x minus a is a factor, then p equal to 0. Again, p equal to 0, then x minus a is a factor of px. So this is the factor theorem. Okay, so this is the corollary of remainder theorem. Now I take an example to understood this factor theorem. Suppose px equal to, again take this polynomial x square plus 5, x square plus 5x, x square plus 5x, and p1 equal to what? 6. Is it 0? No, it's not equal to 0. So according to factor theorem, we can say that x minus 1 is not a factor of px. Okay, so if it is the factor, then it must have to be 0. Take another example. Suppose take another example, px equal to x square minus 1, then p of 1 equal to, what is the value of p of 1? 1 square minus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore x minus 1 is factor of px according to factor theorem, because p of 1 equal to 0, p of 1 equal to 0. So according to factor theorem, if p a equal to 0, then x minus 1, x minus a, that means x minus 1 is a factor of px. So this is the factor theorem. Here I discuss about some algebraic identities. These are the some result, okay, that's the standard result that we use to solve the exercise problem. I just want to discuss about only four algebraic identities, that are x plus y whole square is equal to x square plus 2x plus y square, x minus y whole square equal to x square minus 2x plus y square, x square minus y square, x plus y into x minus y, and x plus a into x plus b equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. So these four algebraic identities you have to use to solve the exercise problem. Okay, and these four you have to remind, because these are the standard result. Okay, so this is the theorem portion of chapter 2 polynomial. In the next video I discuss about the exercise problem of chapter 2 polynomials.